بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته, and welcome to yet another episode of the Special 10 Dhul Hijjah edition. We are joined today by Sheikh Wasim Tarsisi. السلام عليكم شيخ.
بارك الله فيك وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته to yourself and to Unity community.
Thank you very much for joining us for our third installment, and we have actually started with the Islamic studies targets, this being our third session. We'll be talking about the third target. What is the third target here at Unity Grammar for the Islamic studies department?
Yeah, subhanAllah, barakAllahu feek, you know, bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. We have six targets here at Unity Grammar, and the third target that we're speaking about is Sirah. So yeah, that's from the different targets that we concentrate on, and Sirah is the third target, which is obviously about you know, the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, pre-Islamic, in his life and just throughout his life as a biography. Yeah.
And so, why is the Sirah so important for a student or for any Muslim for that matter?
Well, it's a fantastic question, Muhammad. You know, when I you know, thought about this. You know, this topic, and you know, you asking this question now, it's very hard to answer that very easily, because really the seerah, the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for us as Muslims, is really as important as the Quran is important. And why that is because inside the seerah, inside the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we find all of the important events that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he went through, all the important events that the companions they went through, and pretty much knowing the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's what really you know, engraves inside the hearts of the Muslims a great love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's why some of the scholars, they told us from our pious predecessors, our Salaf, they said that we used to teach our students or our children the seerah just as we used to make them memorize the Quran. So you find that the seerah and the Quran would not be taught unless it was coinciding. And wallahi, when you understand that, you find that you know, the Quran and the seerah, it is intertwined together, subhanAllah. So it's very important, the life of the Muslim. Yeah.
And may Allah reward you and the Islamic Studies Department. You're all doing a fantastic job in teaching the seerah. So what do the students learn in the seerah topics that we do cover?
Absolutely. So, you know, inside the seerah, inside the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are a lot of different topics that you will learn. Pre-Islamic, you know, topics and issues that happened before the prophethood of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The main chapters that the students will learn, especially JS and moving up to senior, is obviously, you know, the Meccan period and the Medina period, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he established, you know, his place in Medina, all the different things that happened in Mecca, you know, the very important you know, topics that happened between the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Quraysh, all the struggles that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he went through inside Mecca, and then, as we said, furthering on to Medina, his hijrah to Medina, the great story of the hijrah, you know, the great companionship of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and just the different contributions that the Sahaba they had, especially from his close companions, his senior companions, Umar, Abu Bakr, Uthman, Ali, and the rest. And they will have many different understandings and scopes of, you know, the great history of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in that time, inshallah, bi-idhnillah.
And do students in junior school or in the younger years start learning about the seerah from special significant points in time, or is the teaching of seerah here at Unity Grammar sequential? As in, starts from the birth of the Prophet ﷺ and then goes through all the way to the back.
Good. It's a very good question. Now, you know, prior to me being here, I think we might have taken a different take on how to teach the seerah. At this point, with our new and vibrant and exciting curriculum that we are, working on tirelessly day and night, we are going, inshallah, to teach the seerah in a sequence, starting from the time of the birth of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and as we said, even pre-Islamic, what was happening with the Arabs and Quraysh, and that's very, very important because we have a very close connection to these people, Quraysh and the different tribes around there. So it's in a sequence, yes, and that's what we plan, and that's how we plan to teach, inshallah, so the student can have a consistent level of understanding throughout his years, inshallah.
That's fantastic. So it's about contextualizing and understanding the context where the Prophet ﷺ was born in, the environment, the period, to be able to see the reasons why certain things happened later on in the Prophet ﷺ's life.
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. And there's so many important events that we are all accustomed to. There's very, outward events that, the majority of the Muslims know, but there are so many important events that the students need to know about. And there's a lot of what we call, tarbiyah, which is, really giving them a good upbringing when it comes to the Prophet ﷺ and the history of the Prophet ﷺ, yeah.
Now, how do junior school students study the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ? Is it practical? Is it hands-on? Is there any scope for
teaching? Yeah, barakallahu fiqh. This is another very important question. I think especially now we're transitioning into what we call here at Unity Grammar, as you know, Muhammad, deeper learning. And, deeper learning is something that we are very happy to be introducing to Unity Grammar, me, myself, junior school. So the scope and the way that we want to combine teaching topics like the seerah with the great skills of deeper learning is that it'll be much more of a hands-on approach, much more practical, much more interactive, much more involved. And we want to not denote or look away from the conventional way of teaching from a book, which is very important. That's the original way. But we are now bringing together more practical deep learning skills. For example, if we are learning about the seerah, we're learning about, for instance, the hijrah, we're learning about the Kaaba, we're learning about different things, then we are able to bring in very practical activities that get the mind of the student thinking and more involved, inshallah. So it'll be a much more practical approach, we hope, inshallah.
Inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give yourself, the team, and the students all the success. So carrying on with the idea of deep learning, obviously deep learning is to actually materialize the understanding and the knowledge into a practical sense.
Yes.
So how could the study or the understanding of the seerah benefit our students and the community at large in this life and in the hereafter?
Without a shadow of a doubt. Learning the seerah, learning about the seerah, in benefit to the current life that we live here, the benefits are vast and large, because one of the biggest things that students, that youth today are missing is a correct understanding of their identity. And we find that there is a big identity crisis out there. Muslims, unfortunately, are losing their way, their understanding, their finesse, if you may. One of the biggest reasons you'll find is that the word Muhammad is given to hundreds and thousands of people. And you can vouch for that yourself.
Being one of those 20% of the world population.
Yeah, well, there you go. Allahu Akbar. Yeah. Allahu Akbar. And, that by itself is just amazing. But when we come to kind of, take away the surface and get a bit more deeper, we find that how much do we really know about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So we find that unfortunately there are some bits and pieces of information that are floating that we might be able to grasp, But at the end of the day, we really don't understand Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam as a character. And how does that help in regard to benefiting? It helps because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was the best of creation. He had the best of character. He was a statesman. He was a family person. He was a man of wisdom. He was a person of great leadership. He was a person that we've stood and took on so many struggles and different difficulties in such a very short period of time in Mecca, in Medina, that when you look into his life, you can say nothing short than amazing, the word comes to your mind. So the Muslim today is going through hundreds and thousands of struggles a day, and literally I'm not over exaggerating here, and we need to be able to help them benefit by making that connection and understanding that you have a great identity. Your identity goes back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What struggles are you going through? Let us relate, let us look, and let's upskill and learn how we can live our life and benefit in all ways of life, intellectually, physically, emotionally, spiritually, academically. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was at the absolute forefront of his game. So that's to do with this life. In the afterlife, well, I can say to you that having the correct intention to learn the seerah, to learn the different things about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then having the passion, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells, say, O Muhammad, tell them, O Muhammad, if you truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then follow me and I will truly love them for that. What better way is there to return back to the seerah, to the history, and make that connection in order that I can know how to love the Prophet, and then I will be able to follow him and love him, and the love of Allah will be on me, and the love of Allah can only result in paradise, and that is our eternal abode, and that is the result in the hereafter. And we hope that to be inshallah.
Jazakallah khair. What a beautiful way to sum up what the student experience here at Unity Grammar will be, and the information and the benefits that they will derive out of the third target area, which is the target area of the seerah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Now, in usual manner, before we end the session, we've been used to, with our viewers, to end the session with one sunnah act that the viewers, as well as us, we can practice in these blessed 10 days of the year, the days of Dhul Hijjah. So what would be your recommendation for the listeners and for us to follow in, inshallah?
Absolutely. Barakallahu feek. You know, there's so many great actions, voluntary actions, sunan from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And, you know, they're all very important and highly regarded. Lectures and lectures can be given about all of them, subhanAllah. I always tend to, especially in a school setting, to lean towards one particular worship because it's easy, and we don't get enough of it, and we are in need of it, and it's truly going to be beneficial for us in this life and in the Day of Judgment. And it is just the general remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And why do I pick this worship? It's because even with my challenges with the students to pick their brain and understand, that we find that this remembrance, this worship, is very, very rarely noted or remembered to even be a worship when it comes to the students. And when we ask them, what are different types of worships in our topics, they can tell you the fundamental ones is Salah, Hajj, Ramadan, different things like that. But when it comes to general worship, and we explain to them the importance of that, they literally scratch their mind and say, how do you mean? So remembrance, saying the al-istighfar, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. This by itself, the scholars, they said, if one was to make constant istighfar, constant repentance by saying this, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, constantly on his tongue, the ulama, they said, tuftahu lahu al-futuhat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ulama, they said that the greatest doors that were locked would open for him. And when one says al-istighfar in this manner, tuftahu lahu al-futuhat, the greatest doors, what doors were closed for me for them to be open? This is the question I need to ask. Mm. There are many things that have not been opened for you as a student and us as Muslims, because due to one act that is to make al-istighfar, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his repentance and his forgiveness upon us. So making remembrances, subhanAllah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illa Allahu Akbar, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if I was to say these, it was more better and more greater for me than if the sun was to come up in the morning. So why sometimes we are concentrating on such great actions that could be out of reach for us? Let us give the students something that they have a mastery in. They have a mastery in talking. They have a mastery in replying. They have a mastery in commenting. Let's give them something to fulfill and to challenge them and challenge that muscle they have in their mouth, which is their tongue. So remembrance would be my pick without going further.
And such an easy ibadah, an act of worship. You can do it between classes when you're going from one class to another. When you're doing it, you can do it on your way back from lunch. For the older listeners and viewers, you can do it in between meetings when you're going from job site to another job site. The opportunities are endless. When you're waiting on hold on the phone,
subhanAllah,
make istighfar.
You can use it anywhere. You can use it anywhere. And if I was to leave this school or to leave one thing behind, if I could have a great majority of students just doing istighfar, I would wait for that reward on the day of judgment, inshallah, bi-idhnillah. So it's great. It is absolutely great. Yeah.
Well, jazakallah khairan, Shaykh Wasim. It's been an absolute pleasure to have you. In usual manner, we've exhausted all topics and we've overspoken about everything. May Allah reward you for your time. We thank you very much for covering this very important target area 3, which is the seerah. Dear viewers and listeners, jazakumullah khairan, thank you so much for your time. We say salamu alaykum, and until next time, nastawdaakum Allah alladhi la tudhi'u wada'ah. Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.